Welcome. Inflow's manufacture orders can streamline your manufacturing process and increase efficiency like never before. Manufacture orders allow you to track all components needed for production. Before we start, we'd encourage you to complete the following. Add all products to Inflow, add all product costs, and add a bill of materials for the products you assemble. Check out the bill of materials video to learn how to set that up. If your team does custom work and doesn't use a bill of materials, manufacture orders have options for you too. Go to Main Menu, then New Manufacture Order. This window will list products with a bill of materials. Select a product or click Start from a blank order to build an unlisted product. In this example, we'll build a product with a bill of materials. Select the location for the manufacture order and the quantity you want to build. Then click Create. The top of the page contains all the order information, such as location, order date, and more. You can change any of these details as needed. Next, you'll see View Full Pick List. This option is helpful if you want a single pick list with all components across all assemblies. After building all assemblies, select Complete Order. For manufacturers who build first and update Inflow afterward, the Complete Order button can be used to auto-pick and put away the finished product. Show Raw Materials is a display option showing you all the components needed for the manufacture order. You could toggle it on or off to see more or less information. In the Overview table, you'll see the product information. This table is organized in a hierarchy to help you visualize which products to build first. The top level is the product you're manufacturing, and the lower levels have all the components. We advise you starting from the lowest level assembly and working your way to the top. The reason is the lower level assemblies are likely needed for the higher levels. Before we continue, if your assemblies and components have inventory status badges that say low stock, blocked, or not enough, click on these badges to open the reorder settings. When you have enough stock, these statuses will clear and you could start manufacturing. You can learn more about these badges by checking out the manufacture order article. You can find the link in the description. The first step in assembling the product is picking. There are two picking options. Flat picking, where you pick all components for the entire order using a full pick list. The second option is to pick per assembly. In this case, you pick as you go and only pick the components in the assembly you're working on. In this example, we'll pick per assembly. On the subassembly, click Start. If you completed picking the subassembly beforehand, select Pick All. Otherwise, check off the other raw materials you pick as you go. Or if you prefer to use a scanner, select Scan to pick. From here, you can click on the back arrow to return to the overview table or click Assemble to start building. If you're building a product with a bill of materials that has operations, also known as manufacturing routing, you'll see all the assembly steps here. The times added to the operations are estimates. When the operation is complete, enter the completion time in the duration field. This will give an accurate manufacturing cost for the product you're building. When starting, the first operation is highlighted. Click Mark as done when the operation is complete. Repeat this process until all operations are finished. If some operations were skipped, you can hover over them and click the X to remove them. At the bottom of the operation table, you can click Add Operation if you want to add an operation that isn't listed. If you prefer to complete the operations all at once, select Mark All as Done. When the operations are complete, click back to Overview to return to the main screen. The subassembly we were working on is now marked as done. To continue building, click Start on the remaining subassemblies on the Overview table. At any point, you can set a put-away location where the product will be located once manufactured. If you don't want to set a put-away location, Inflow will use the location set on the order. In the order header, click on Set Put-away Location. Select the main location, sublocation, and quantity. You can split the quantities into multiple sublocations or add a new main location and move some of the quantities there. Select Put-away when done. If you'd like to make any changes to the order, such as editing the quantity or swapping out a product, hover over the component and select the ellipsis for options. You could do this on both the overview table and on the picking screens. For a complete guide on other changes you can make, take a look at the Customizing Manufacturer Orders article linked in the description. When the manufacturing is done, select Complete Order. This will deduct the quantity levels from all the components on the order and increase the quantity of all products that have been built. We hope this video helped you learn more about how to manufacture products in Inflow. For an in-depth look at manufacturer orders, we'd encourage you to check out the article linked in the description. As always, you can contact the Inflow team if you have any questions. Thanks for watching.